friends, it's Angelina and Dima from Okeanche World, and it's our second day of GR11. Today we want to get from Refugi de Malniu to the shelter Espravals, doing around 10 kilometers or so, and elevation change would be 800 meters up and 800 meters down.
So today we won't be doing a big distance neither, the same as yesterday, because we want to get to our destination earlier and also want to film some beautiful scenes on the way, stop and surrender. And the other reason is that we don't want to spend the night at the high elevation, like 2500 meters. We don't think it's very safe and nice, especially if thunderstorm is coming. So we planned our stages this way that we always stay overnight at maximum elevation of 2000 meters, ideally less, like 1000 something. And so yeah, so this is our plan for today. Let's begin the day.
We slept quite well because the night was quiet, but unexpectedly there was a bit of rain this night.
Yeah, and we actually heard a bit of a thunder in the distance. Fortunately, it wasn't very close to us, but as we already know, for the mountains it's probably normal, like, to have a bit of rain from time to time. Fortunately, we won't have it at midday and during the day. Luckily, we found more or less flat spots, so we were sleeping quite comfortably. It wasn't a problem. Now, as you can see, we're using different technique of storing the sleeping bag that we discovered just recently. One kind guy in the comment section where we did the review of this sleeping bag, Edgesmax, recommended us to try it and said that it's actually better for the sleeping bag rather than just rolling them as we did before. Stacking the bag is more healthy, so to say, for the bag, for the down bag especially, because the down is not compressed that much. And yeah, and it seems very easy technique actually, and kind of like it. It's even easier, so that is fine. Here with the stand, because it's so high and has like the hooks, we can actually use our rope and clothes pin right inside for just drying up some small clothes, or like here it's our small towel. And this is really great actually, because we still have quite a lot of space. It's possible to use it in different ways. So cool. Here I wanted to show you how we decided to store our tent, just for now. So in this long sack we have our fly sheet with the tent poles, and here we have our ground sheet in a separate plastic bag and the tent body. The reason why we decided to separate the tent parts is because we want to be able to fast set up for the tent whenever we are in a storm or in bad weather. We want just to be able to set up our fly sheet with the tent poles and that's it, so that we can sit and wait for the weather to get better. And then if the fly sheet gets dirty or wet, it won't wetten the tent body and there won't get any dirt, so it's really nice to keep them separate for it as well. So yeah, we think that this separate storage would work just fine, and we'll keep you updated how it goes. can see here behind us some kind of a campsite zone, and we see that on the sign it says that you need to register at the refugee house. Potentially you can stay here for a day or several days, we are not sure. So it's type of wild campsite, but you have to register for it. Don't really see much sense in it, rather than just if you would like to stay, you know, for a couple of days, probably it's a solution, but just for one night it's better to be out in the wild with no people, just in our opinion. But it's good to know. And there is also a big parking lot where we see a lot of camper vans and stuff. So it seems to be quite a popular area to stay at. Now we're searching for the source of water, which is obviously not here. In the refugee house there is no any. So we probably need to find some clean river creek and filter some water there. So let's go find it.
Today's morning started with cloudy weather and the cool wind felt so nice on the body.
Right, and now the sun is coming up again. The sky is clearing up. We were afraid that we're gonna be hit by the same heat wave. We don't wanna do it because yesterday was quite bad. Actually tonight I had quite a bit of a headache. I think it was because of that heat yesterday and no shadow at all. So hopefully today is gonna be better. You can see right here on this river creek that there is a crossroad and there are no signs of GR11, any signs, and we had to use our GPS navigation and it showed us that the way up where the most of the people are going, are heading, it is leading to the peak Puig Pedros, which is probably one of the popular destinations, and our way is actually taking the left side, no? If you're facing this river creek this way, so we're taking from the crossroad the left direction and going along this mountain cliff. So it's important not to mix it up here.
For now the trail has been quite easy. We had a bit of an uphill at the start and now we're going gently downhill. So we've been enjoying the variety of this trail.
I feel like we have slowed down our pace significantly because the path becomes very narrow and often you have to skip over the roots of the tree or the big rocks. Also, there is times when there's really steep downhill with the small rocks. So here the trekking poles are helping a lot to me, and I'm enjoying using them to keep in the balance. Right now we have 450 meters uphill and 600 meters of downhill approximately. So we're going good. I think it will take us around 2.5 hours or so. And it's still not the hottest time of the day. So we're going great right now. Here in these places, we are so looking forward to meet the mountain goats and some marmots. Now we've spotted just one baby marmot, but he hid it very quickly on the rock. But still, we're hoping to get it on camera. This area that we're passing by right now is very reminiscent to us to the Lake Buyuz area in Picarlit that we recently hiked in. We hiked there actually several times, and also Val de Nuria in some places, which is really close to our heart.
We have full playlist dedicated to the hikes in Pyrenees, so if you're interested, check it out. We highly recommend it, it's very beautiful.
I will leave the link here on the screen and down below. Fortunately, we have found the shadow under the rock in this sunny kingdom with no trees. Now we're gonna have our lunch. People adventurous enough to have a swim in this lake. We don't think it's gonna be too warm, to be honest with you, but it looks tempting. We're heading to the snow, to where the snow is left. Wow, so exciting. Now we'll have to conquer this steep uphill. This looks quite steep compared to what we already did before, yesterday and today. And yeah, so it's probably like maybe 1 kilometer or so, but can you see how steep it is? So in the mountains, distance doesn't work. Elevation rules the world. Thank you. of uphill, you can see here. It doesn't look very, very extreme, but it will be challenging for sure because it's kind of lone. And yeah, and overall the challenge of this trail is that you have to constantly go downhill and then uphill again. That is what we're gonna do now. We're gonna go downhill very much and then uphill even more. Fortunately, the uphill wasn't too difficult nor too long, but now we have the downhill in front of us and we'll see if it's gonna be the same easy. Hope it's not gonna have a lot of small rocks where it's easy to sleep on. Almost all the way down. The downhill turned out to be quite tedious and long. It's just, I think, 3 kilometers, but still it just feels a lot, like it took the hell out of us. And we definitely can't do any more kilometers today, so gonna go all the way down now and search for the place to camp.
So we have found a place for tonight, close to the river, more or less flat surface, away from the trails. Today wasn't an easy day, as we expected. It was quite hard, especially the long downhill, in direct sunlight, without any shadow.
Yeah, so we still today couldn't manage to escape the hottest time of the day. We were hit by the heat wave again, but now fortunately we'll have time to rest and just to relax in the shadow, and we'll be all good to go and recover for tomorrow, because tomorrow is a big day. Not sure how many kilometers, but very long uphill and then some kilometers of downhill. And we expect it to be the most challenging of all, but potentially the most beautiful too. So stay tuned for that. And for now, we're gonna rest now. We already had our shower, gonna have our dinner and sleep. So see you tomorrow. Bye guys. We have found now, just with 2 days of using the wood stove, that this dry moss works the best to put off the fire. Don't know why, because it's so dry, or it's just the best. No dry branches or pine cones, they don't help, and it's very difficult. But with these plants, it's very easy. So our today's dinner is very delicious. We added the dried tomatoes, some dehydrated mushrooms, shiitake mushrooms, and also we had already the prepared mix of rice with some carrot, I think, a bit of onion, and of course spices, our favorite spices, turmeric, oregano. I forgot to mention also we added the buckwheat to this mix, so this is like the upscale dinner today. Also today's evening we're enjoying the nicest weather. Check it out. Yeah, this is our camp spot. It's so idyllic. The weather is so warm. So grateful for the moments like this. We learn to appreciate these moments because not always and not every day the weather is the same. Today is the perfect type of weather.
Thank you so much for watching. Leave a comment below to let us know how you like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more hiking adventures. Don't forget to hit the bell to stay notified about every new video. Also visit our website walkingnatureworld.com to find detailed hike reports with pictures and maps. Have a beautiful day everybody, and until very soon!